You know, I wish these drones attracted chicks as quick as they do some old guy with two little dogs. No matter where I go with it, obviously, the minute it gets up in the air, everybody's like, ooh, ah, what is that? Talk to me, tell me what's going on. Hey, I'm in the middle of a video production here, huh? So last week, we tested the batteries out on Blackbird 1, and we found out that we weren't getting that advertised flight times. Well, silly me. You're supposed to fly it longer than the 25% first warning you get on battery. I was not. I contacted 3DR. 3DR support said, try and fly it between 10 and 15%, and then you'll get your times. Silly me. The other thing we're going to test out today is return to home, and that's because I found out that there was a parameter on Solo that wasn't set the way I thought it should have been. Going back to the APM days, on a return to launch, the aircraft, I've noticed in a lot of videos, the aircraft does not turn around and fly back facing the pilot, it flies backwards. It just makes an immediate beeline back home. Well, that's kind of silly. So also contacted 3DR about that because I wanted to change the parameter, and he said, yeah, go ahead. And I'll explain the parameter a little later, but for right now, trust me. So the parameter is called WP yaw behavior. Currently, when you get your Solo, it is set to the number 2, which means face every waypoint instead, but don't do it for return to launch or return to home. Well, that's kind of silly. However, they did tell me that during a return to launch, you do have the ability to use your yaw. It's not in the manual. I looked all over that manual. I didn't see it. You can use your yaw to turn it around and face you, thus making a better view, I guess. You know, because why would you want to like look at something coming backwards? Well, how the hell do you know what's in front of you? Right? Ooh, look at that. That's a big plane. There you go. Shiny. Let's put Solo up and fly and see how well we do. We're going to do a fly around just to see if I can see the screen very well without the shade on it, because it's a little hard to reach inside there. Yeah, I know. That's what she said. Here we go. Blackbird 1, alley-o. So I thought those shades were doing some pretty good. Of course, it's not a very good day out. It's cloudy, but I can see that pretty good. We're gonna do a quick return to home without the setting, and then change the setting where it turns around and faces you, and then we're gonna do one with the setting, so you can see the difference. So as you can see here, Solo's now in return to home, and it's coming back pretty good. Beeline straight back, but you can see it's flying backwards. Who wants that? Not me. Now what I'm told is during this time you do have control of everything except the throttle until it starts to land. You can go left or right, and I've now taken control, so. But now I'm gonna send it out and do the other return to home. There you go, you see it spun around. Now it's coming back. Really right above me. Turning around. And coming down nice and sweet, as always, flashing its lights because it does that. Double take control, we'll hit the fly button. And it'll stop, and I'm now in fly, and there you go. Advanced return to home. So now that it's just like a cloudy day, really wasn't worth driving out anywhere. It could actually rain at any moment, so I just really, really wanted to get this down on tape or video and show you guys how that works. So let's just fly around, and we are timing the battery right now. I started a minute late, on the timing, so we'll just add a minute to it at the end, but let's go past the 25% point and see what happens. I love how nice it bangs. It just like goes zoom. As far as the return to home switch, I will explain that in the car, but I'm telling you right now, you best know what you're doing when you do that, because you can mess up a whole lot of things. Now, the only reason I know about it is because I did the APM 2.6 a long, long time ago, and that actually gave me the experience to know that that parameter existed and to change it. Be careful. You don't really have to do this. I just prefer it that way because I, first of all, like when it turns around by itself. And two, I like when it turns around and lands. That's what I like about it the best. So, that said, should you decide to do it, these are steps to how to do it. And I'll show you screenshots of each one. To get the tower application, you just go up to the Play Store. I'm not gonna do that, I've already done that, so I don't think that's too hard to do. So you hit tower. And then in settings, change your connection type to UDP, and once you've changed it to UDP, you can connect to your Solo. Just go over here and hit connect. Once you're connected to Solo, you'll see some markings here, your batteries and all that stuff, where you are. I'm currently inside, so I'm not going to get any kind of GPS fix, but you come over and you hit parameters, and you'll see it says refreshing parameters. First thing you want to do is save this profile, so if you mess anything up, you can always reload it again. But you save this profile first, then you can go scroll all the way down to the end of this list. And it's this parameter right here that will change the Solo to automatically turn and face home, then turn tail in and land. So, with Jack Frost trying to push his face down into Florida, and old man Summer saying no, 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 no. And fighting them back. They're like two drunks on a Saturday night, you know, fighting each other. They can't even slap each other in the face. They're like, bleh, bleh. So Mighty Thor from somewhere in the beautiful city of Tampa, Florida, being an evil mad scientist and touching inside where it's not supposed to on a Solo. Ooh, ooh, clear!